Well, again, my name is Isaac. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my personal medicine and the way I've learned to deal with a lot of things in my life and the way I've helped myself deal with a lot of things in life. First of all, I have a family. I have a wife and daughter, which is really a wonderful part of my personal medicine. Whenever I look at my daughter, I feel so grateful to be alive, and the wonder of having a child and guiding that child is a wonderful experience. I'm also very interested in art, and I've been painting for over 20 years, and that's really been a catalyst in my recovery. I remember there was a time in my life when I was on pill medication, and I stopped painting for 2 years, and it was one of the worst times of my life when I didn't have the way to exert my energy and my emotions, which I do on canvas. It's like taking away a breath of your life. It's like stopping to breathe. And that's how personal medicine has worked for me in a way, because when I'm not using it, when I'm not using things like walking in nature, when I'm not using things like doing my art or doing photography and music, all the personal medicine tools that I use to help me in my recovery, it's like I'm not breathing. It's like something is missing from my life. And all I can tell you is, medication and therapy may be, something that's helpful, but it's not enough. You need to take things into your own hands, rediscover your life. I'm sure there are things that you've done in the past that were interesting to you, whether it be walking in the woods, fishing on a lake, swimming, playing with a pet. I mean, pets are wonderful. I have friends who have pets, and we're actually getting a pet for my daughter very soon. So I'm looking forward to that, adding that to my personal medicine arsenal. Everyone has to have like sort of arsenal of their personal medicine, because going and taking medication and a therapeutic community may be fine, but it doesn't reach inside you. It doesn't let you emotionally deal with a lot of things. My art, for example, has been really something. I'm able to let my whole, any way I'm feeling, whether it be anger, whether it be emotional turmoil, I'm able to release that on canvas. I find it a wonderful release. If you don't need expensive things, you can buy crayons, pastels, paper. Just sit down, let yourself go. Don't worry about how it looks. That's the most important thing. And don't worry what you use as personal medicine. No one's personal medicine is better than someone else's. Whether it be a walk in the woods, whether it be fishing on a lake, whether it be sitting in the sunshine, whatever works for you is the important thing. Art works for me, but it may not work for everyone. And I hope you will really take this advice to heed, because it's helped me dramatically in my life. I've really come to a place in my life where I'm able to cope both emotionally and physically with the stimulus around me. Due to my diagnosis of paranoid schizophrenia, sometimes the stimulus can be overwhelming. But when you have something that you're able to delve into, including meditation, just deep breathing, anything that helps you personally, that's a wonderful thing. And I advise you to use whatever you can find. And if you need to discuss it further, find a peer support group where people are able to help you deal with your issues and to focus on what your personal medicine could be. And try a number of things. It'll be helpful to you. Thank you so much.